promised we would not use his name or face to ensure his safety. News 9 producer Alex Burkholder has tonight's report.
A school burns on Chicago's west side. It's December 1st, 1958. 92 students and 3 nuns die. Almost 21 years later, August 20th, 1979, a man confesses on film that he accidentally started that blaze while sneaking a smoke in a stairwell of the half-century-old school building. But what was he doing there? Going back to the day of the school fire, you said you had some trouble prior.
Well,
was it an argument with your sister or something of this nature?
Yes, then it was an argument between me, my sister, and my mother. And she wanted me to do something, and I didn't want to do it.
You remember what, offhand?
Not at the present. I think it was about wanting me to go back to the school. And I didn't want to go back to the school.
You didn't like the training school?
No, because the rules were too strict. And if you could ask these two gentlemen here, they could tell you the rules are strict down at that school. If you got caught out of bounds, you were punished. And I couldn't stand being what you call chained up. I had to be moving. And they wanted me to go back, and I didn't want to go back. So
you went across the street. You were not a student in Our Lady of Angels.
No, I was never a student in that building.
And you just wandered into the building,
yes.
And then the fire ensued.
In other words, to cool off, to settle down, so I go home and...
To grab a smoke.
Yeah. So I go home, be in a sane mind when I get home, to tell them that I'm not going back, instead of going back in there hot, mad, the way I was.
The question of truth, it comes up during the interview with the man who is in his 30s and on parole for arson and murder. If someone were to walk up to you now and say, you're a liar, what would your reaction be?
That's his prerogative to call me what he wants. But I know the truth. The only way he could say I was a liar if he did it himself.
Chief George Schuler of the Chicago Fire Department believes the man is telling the truth. Schuler's quest for truth had to be financed from his own pocket and on his own time because, according to Schuler, the late fire commissioner Robert Quinn was uninterested in pursuing the story of a woman who said her brother had started the school fire.
Did she just assume you had done it, or did she see you do it?
I don't know, but she said it. She knew I did it. I don't know how she found out, or who told her, or if she seen me or not. But she said she knew I did it. And that's what she told Chief. And to my knowledge, I believe she did know. How, I don't know.
Assisted by author John Kunster, Schuler established that the arsonist was living near the school at the time of the tragic blaze. A photograph taken by Schuler the day of the fire, when studied years later, would show the young arsonist at the scene. And then there's a confession. But why?
You didn't have to confess. You didn't
did it. I didn't have to say nothing.
Did you do it to ease your mind? Was that the thing?
I did it just to relieve myself of the pressure that was been on me for the past so many years.
With the Our Lady of the Angels school fire behind him, the arsonist starts fires on Chicago's near north side and winds up going to prison. That story Wednesday. This is Alex Burkholder for News 9.
This series on the Our Lady of the Angels school fire can be seen exclusively this week on the 10 o'clock news and night beat on WGN television